Neoplatonists were working with the principle of wisdom. They were elevating not the mind, but something beyond and superior to the mind, to first place in the contemplation of reality. Whereas in Gnosticism, universal deity was the absolute good. In Neoplatonism, the absolute or universal deity was absolute truth. And in this, we have an entirely different premise, although the words in practical experience often seem to become synonymous. They are synonymous upon levels. The philosopher was working to achieve the experience of that truth which solves all error or refutes all error. He assumed, therefore, the existence in space of a quality known as truth. He was perfectly willing to assume that this truth was an attribute of deity. But in some way, the Neoplatonic concept of deity was this all-truthfulness. And he would say that if a thing is all-truthful, it is also all-good. Therefore, a thing that is truthful is good, whereas the Gnostic might have reversed it in the religious position and said, a thing that is good must be truthful. It was a different approach with the postulation of a different end. The mystic of the Gnostic school, seeking this end, which is the all-embracing love of God. Whereas the Neoplatonists sought that end as the all-embracing understanding by means of which he himself might experience the state of total truth. Now, he sought truth not from the selfish intellectual desire, as Plotinus very clearly points out. He did not wish to be assumed to know more than other men. He was not of the type who wanted to get up and say, this is the truth. His truth was beyond articulation, in word or even in thought. His truth approached a mystical experience in itself. But whereas one had the infinite believing of the Gnostic, the other had the strange desire to believe through knowing, that the individual can never be sure till he knows. Therefore, the development of the power to know, until this knowledge revealed all things knowable and all things necessary, represented largely the Neoplatonic position. Neoplatonism arose then as an effort to link the philosophy of Plato with the need for a spiritual, emotional experience of truth. This experience of truth could not be merely the transference of information. No individual could say to another man confidentially, this is the truth. Even if it was so, and even if the statement was true, there could be no communication of truth apart from a dynamic experience which involved the immediate sense of internal knowing on the part of the person to whom the so-called truth was communicated. Truth could never be anything worldly. It could never be the truth about planets or comets or the tides or the seasons. This truth had to be the all-truth, which was man's experience of the true discovery of his relationship to everything that exists, including himself. And in order to have this experience, he must also have the full experience of the wonderful world structure to which he was intimately related. He must not only think of God and about God, he must think with God. So Neoplatonism was this search for truthful thinking. Thinking with the mind of God. Thus, as the Hermetic philosophers might have assumed God to be absolute law. And the Gnostic school, absolute good or absolute virtue. So in the Theopotonic school, God was the continuous state of absolute knowing. God knows all things. God is a state of eternal knowing without center or circumference. That which knows all things notes also the sparrow's fall. God is a universal knowing beyond mind, a knowing which is seated in the heart, mind structure of every creature, so that man is capable of a kind of knowing that is without mind. A kind of knowing that is strangely passionless, and yet when experienced, is a total experience from which no part of the being can escape, and which causes afterwards the individual to say, with a strange finality of revelation, I know. Yet this same person could not say what he knows, because his knowledge is not of things, but of the eternal value which lies beneath all things. Thus knowing in Neoplatonism is practically and functionally this internal power to know value, to apperceive or apprehend essential essence in things, and to experience identity with essence. Neoplatonism, therefore, would follow in the Buddhist concept that while man seems to have a mind and seems to have a knowing power, he is actually knowing with the mind of God, whether he knows it or not. And this mind, which seems to be his, is actually an eternal mind, the eternity of which he has not recognized or accepted before.